Exactly, humble. It's humiliation kind of. So many times I always tell people that they think Jupiter, Saturn both represent humility. Have you heard this?
Right. Oh yes.
Yeah, they will say Jupiter is humility because it represents good qualities, right?
Right.
And Saturn also represents humility. So how can it be that one thing is represented by both? No, actually, it's not true actually. Jupiter represents humility naturally, natural humility. Like when you go to a guru, you are humble, you are bowing down and etc. Right. Saturn represents humiliation.
Right.
When yes. somebody humiliates you, then you are forced to become humble.
Yes, yes. Beautiful.
Bali Maharaj, out of this hatred which Shukracharya has for the devatas, he poisoned him so terribly that go and do Ashwamedh yagya and become Indra, because anybody who does 100 Ashwamedh yagyas becomes Indra.
Right.
So in that, this thing can also be seen that something which you are planning to hit, na, that 100th yagya, that may not be successful for you.
Right.
So that also I have seen sometimes. If this is active, then people tell that, okay, you know, I wanted to do this, everything happened. But the last step,
missing.
Last thing did not happen. But then what happened? That did not happen for Bali Maharaj. And then Vamandev said that. Then he was very happy when he said, "Put it on my head." No?
Right.
Then what happened? Bali Maharaj, Vamandev was so happy. He gave him a lot of boons actually.
Right.
So then the first boon which he got was, many people may not know this, that's why I'm just adding. If you
no,
don't.
No, it's good, good, good. It's good to mention this.
The first boon he gave was, in the next Manvantara is the cycle of devatas, you know, like one person is Indra for one Manvantara, one Manu.
Right.
So in one day of Brahma, there are 14 Manus, if you calculate like that. And every Manu lives for 76 Divya Yugas. One Divya Yuga is Satya Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Treta Yuga, Kali Yuga combined. Right. So this four is one Divya Yuga.
Right.
Like this, if you take 76 Divya Yugas, it's a very complex calculation, of course. So he said, in the next Manvantara,
right.
I bless you that you will be the Indra.
Indra.
So, you may feel, if Shravan is active or you have a planet in Shravan, you may feel that, oh, what I wanted did not happen.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it will happen at some other time, you will see.
Right. Yes.
Then second boon he gave was, till the time this Manvantara is going on, you will go to Sutala.
Yes, the Netherland.
Yeah, so there is this Bhuloka is there, then Atal, Vital, Sutal, Talatra. Patal, Mahatal, Patal is the last. So Sutal is one of the lower planetary systems, but surprisingly in Srimad Bhagavatam it is mentioned, it is more opulent than Indra's heavenly planets.
Yeah.
So you will be ruling in Sutal, alright, and your reign will be undisturbed. Nobody will challenge you till the time you are there. And you will be there till this Manvantara.
Yeah.
So it's like you are the undisputed ruler of Sutal. Something like this.
Right.
And three steps you said. So Vamandev gave three boons. So these two boons. First boon was you will become Indra in next Manvantara. Right. Then you will be ruler of Sutal. And right. third boon he said, I will personally become the doorkeeper. The security guard of Sutal. Anybody comes, I have to. They have to pass through me.
Right.
And this third benediction was so bad.
Right.
That because Vishnu had taken avatar and he had come, so Vaikuntha was empty.
Empty. Yeah.
And then Lakshmi Devi was feeling very bad that where is my husband? I cannot stay without my husband.
Yeah.
And all the Vaikuntha Vasis, they were unable to stay actually.
Yep.
And one day what happened? Bali Maharaj was doing charity in Sutal.
Right.
Then Lakshmi Devi at the last, she came as a very old lady. She disguised.
Yeah.
And then he asked, so my dear mother, what do you want? He said, my husband is with you. Please give me your husband. Give your
yep.
my husband back. And then Bali Maharaj said, who's your husband? He said, yes, this boy standing there is my husband. And then Vamandev said that I had given promise that I will stay here, so I cannot go now. But then if I am not there, then Vaikuntha will be empty. So I cannot tolerate that you people are unhappy. So he expanded into a Vishnu form, and that form went to Vaikuntha, and Vamandev stayed there.
Right.
So that is very important to understand, that if you have this nakshatra prominent, you might externally feel that what you wanted, you did not get.
Right. But very important thing.
Actually, you will get something even better.
Yes.
Much, much, much better. Or what you wanted could happen at a later stage.
Stage. Yes.
Okay.
So, and those who are curious to know when we will get it, the tentative time frame line for that is either in Jupiter Antardasha, Mahadasha, or in Saturn Antar or Mahadasha.
Okay.
That is the time frame when you might get it.
Yes.
And you have mentioned, sir, very good point, because letting of ego is very important in this nakshatra. Only then you will get big.
Yeah.
And if you're still not letting it go, don't forget Saturn is in Capricorn. Next year it will be in Shravana. He will make sure you listen to me.
And another important thing is there here. This is very important. We should understand. If you read the Bali Maharaj's story in Srimad Bhagavatam, you will find when Bali Maharaj said, put the third foot over my head, then everybody chastised him. All the demons were chastising him. What a disgrace, what a ruler we have who has given the entire world like a present to his enemy.
Right.
What a misfortune we have. What kind of a ruler we have. So it can happen that you have done everything for your subordinates, for your relatives, for your friends, your family members. Bali Maharaj's wife was criticizing him.
Right.
Bali Maharaj's relatives were criticizing him. Your guru is criticizing you. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
So it can happen that for that small moment, the entire world turns against you.
Yeah.
And you may feel that, why am I living? Better I should have died. Or you may doubt yourself that, oh, I should have not done like this maybe. But then what should you do when you get these doubts?
Right.
Then what did Bali Maharaj do? Well, he was thinking that, who are my ancestors? My ancestors are somebody like Hiranyakashyap. Yes. These are great demons who were killed personally by Lord Vishnu. But who was the son of Hiranyakashyap? He's Prahlad Maharaj himself.
Right.
Yes. So he's Prahlad Maharaj is his direct ancestor. Virochan is in between. Right? Virochan and then Prahlad. So his grandfather.
Yeah.
So he recalled his grandfather Prahlad Maharaj, who is one of the 12 Mahajans. Prahlad is one of the 12 Mahajans.
Right.
And Bali is also one of the 12 Mahajans. These 12 personalities are certified great personalities.
Yeah.
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, whose examples we are supposed to follow. So we are supposed to follow them, but here you see that one Mahajan is also following another Mahajan.
Yeah.
This is the most beautiful thing. And he recalled the sufferings which Prahlad Maharaj had faced because of his father, Hiranyakashyapu. Hiranyakashyapu had thrown him in the pit of snakes and from mountain and in a pot of oil to fry him, but then nothing happened.
Right.
So he recalled that if this Vamandev is that same Narsingh Bhagwan who came and protected Prahlad Maharaj.
Right.
So if that same Vishnu protected Prahlad Maharaj,
right,
why will he let me go down?
Right.
Why? So when you are also in such a situation that you feel everybody, your husband, your wife, your even your guru, my God, included your guru. is against you, right, then what should you do? Then you should recall Prahlad Maharaj, because that is the most, because that surrender which Bali Maharaj did, that Shukracharya told him that this boy, he's not a small boy, he's Vishnu, and I know why he has come. He's going to strip you and you are going to be a pauper for the rest of your life.
Right.
So imagine if you know somebody is going to make you a pauper.
Right.
Will you ever give him that charity? I mean, no sane person will give, right?
Exactly.
But he gave, and that is why he's Bali Maharaj. That is why he's one of the 12 Mahajans. He could have said, some other time we will do it, Kabhi baad mein aaiye na. Like I've seen sometimes when holy people, sadhus come to home sometimes, people, they will give certain things, but then they're like, ha ha, kal denge, phir se aaiye, come tomorrow, I will give you. So, but Bali Maharaj did not do like, he knew that this, so then he was thinking of Prahlad Maharaj, and then he was humiliated, and everybody was against him. So it can happen that if you have prominent planets, or if you have severe afflictions and you are running the dasha 10 times, I am saying some dasha related to Shravana, of course.
Right.
Not Moon Mahadasha or Moon Antardasha. It can be any planet in Shravana. That planet Antardasha can also do the job.
Yes.
And if the 8th house is associated, provided,
right,
then you might face humiliation. But even if you face, what you should do, you should remember Prahlad Maharaj, that yes, he was protected. So now maybe, like for Bali Maharaj, Vamandev came and he tested him. No?
Yeah.
So maybe now Lord Narayan is testing me also. Maybe I have some desire which is not good.
Good.
And that is why Vamandev did not let Bali Maharaj complete the 100th Ashwamedh Yagya, because if Bali would have completed that, then what would have happened?
Right.
He's descendant of Prahlad Maharaj, so he has this greatness in him. He's a Mahajan. But because he's still in that demoniac family, in that Rakshas school, and association of Shukracharya and other demons,
right,
although he's a great personality, but he got polluted.
Right.
But that greatness was there inside him.
Right.
Otherwise, he could not have given the promise, right?
Right.
So, don't forget your greatness. Don't forget your roots. Don't forget where you came from. Don't forget those people who have given their lives for you. And don't just listen to the superficial people who are just, praising you all the time. The demons used to praise Bali Maharaj. Why? Because Bali would win wars, they would enjoy, right?
Right.
So this is crucial, that you don't make decisions because just others are praising you. Stick to dharma, stick to what is right, stick to what Prahlad Maharaj did, and then you will also become like Bali Maharaj. You will become like one of the 12 Mahajans. And then later on you will realize, like Bali Maharaj, that you got something much more valuable actually.
Right.
That's what Lord Vishnu did. He came as Vaman. He saw that Bali is a great soul, but he has this superficial covering. So what happened when Bali was humiliated? When Bali became a beggar, what happened? He saw the real face of his associates. All those demons were praising him all the time, superficially. Oh, Bali, you are great. If you read, you will know how they used to praise him. You are like God only. You can do anything. You are all powerful. What happened? Now when he's a beggar, then you are humiliating him, then you are criticizing him, then you are telling, oh alas, what kind of a leader we have. It is our durbhagya, our misfortune. So now suddenly that God has become a beggar for you now. Yeah, bhagya has become durbhagya for you now. So Bali Maharaj came to know that yes, I am staying with these crooks, and thank God I saw their real face. So even if you see that when something happens and you are humiliated, and right, others are insulting you, then don't worry. It will pain you. You will be uncomfortable. But You will see their real faces.
And the same thing, sir.
Yeah.
And the same thing, sir, because few of the points suddenly came to my mind when you were mentioning about Parlaji ancestors. If you suddenly one theme came, the eagle is the bird associated with Magha Nakshatra. And Garudev is the king of eagles.
Yeah, yeah.
So there has some connection with Shravana and Magha. There has to be some. And if you make Shravana the Lagna, the Magha falls in the 8th house.
Wow.
Which you were, so exactly all the themes which you were mentioning were just suddenly coming to my mind. There has to be some deep connection with Magha.
Yeah, because ultimately it's about the throne only, right? Magha.
Yes, yes.
And that's what he did. And when Bali Maharaj takes the vow, he takes right. the water and he says, I vow to give Vamandev 3 steps of land, knowing that would lead to disaster. You know?
Disaster. Again, all the 8th house theme.
Yeah, then he says that I am the grandson of Prahlad. And on his name, I am taking this vow. He says this.
Right.
So, he doesn't say, I am great grandson of Hiranyakashipu. He doesn't say that. Or he doesn't say, I am son of Virochan.
Right.
He identifies with Prahlad Maharaj.
Yeah.
There are 3 ancestors.
Right.
He would have identified with Hiranyakashipu or Virochan also, but he doesn't.
Right.
He identifies with Prahlad Maharaj. So, that shows how great he was. And then, so it's like finally he came to see the reality that these selfish people around me, they were always praising me. Why? Yeah. Because they had their own agendas. If I become the king of heavens, you know, they can also enjoy the heavens.
Right.
And now ultimately I have seen that finally. And one last thing I will share and then you can continue. In the beginning of the presentation, you said, right, if there is a mistake or something like this, right, you said, right.
Right.
So, I wanted to tell that time only, but I recall now, so I'm telling now.
Yeah, please. So,
when all this, the whole episode is over and everything is now normal and Bali Maharaj is now, he has gone to Sutal.
Sutal.
And Indra is very happy that he's still there.
He got his position.
For till this Manvantara he is and the Indra, of course.
Right.
So, then Balima, then Vamandev asks a question to Shukracharya. That, my dear Shukracharya, what happened? Your disciple was stripped of everything. He became a beggar. No? And so, what is your opinion on this actually? And then Shukracharya, although he's a guru of the demons, but it doesn't mean he's a fool. It doesn't mean he doesn't know the scriptures.
Yeah.
He says, it is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. If somebody knows, they can put the number of the shloka. I'll be very happy. He says that, whatever has happened, whatever mistakes, whatever discrepancies that has happened, but at the end, whoever chants your name, everything is nullified.
Yeah. And again, that is one of the biggest remedies because everybody, we all want remedies.
Yes.
Biggest remedy for Shravana native, and I think it is a universal remedy, which I wanted to mention at the end, is to chant or recite Vishnu Sahasrana.
Yes.
Biggest remedy for Shravana native.
I also started that playlist in my channel, surprisingly.
Great. And another thing one can do, one can do for this nakshatra is, which I wanted to put, read more about Garuda Dev, read Garuda Puran. If you are lacking courage in life, if you are lacking all the traits which I have mentioned in the earlier slides, learn or read more about Garuda Puran. You will strengthen your Shravana, trust me.
Yes, Garuda Puran you can read. Similar stories are in the Padma Puran. Similar stories are in this whole episode, which I said was from 8th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, Srimad Bhagavatam, 8th canto you can read.
Okay.
So, you will really greatly benefit whoever is watching this. So, you will get all the lessons. Everything is there.
Yeah. Okay, sir. going back to some more general traits which I have seen consistently working bang on with Shravana natives, which you have just mentioned in the last slide. Just like the Mahabali, he was so generous of giving his land. And you will find Shravana natives very generous in nature. They love giving things. Again, depending upon your full chart, again, the disclaimer, what he has mentioned, it will depend. If it's afflicted, if it's sitting in a bad dignity, then you will be the biggest miser in the house.
Okay.
Who cannot share anything.
Okay.
But generally, I have seen 9 out of 10 times very generous in nature, and because of their generosity, they will get into debts.
Okay.
If it is connected with the 6th Lord, 8th Lord, definitely you will get into debts. And I have seen that. Suppose, let me give you a real life example. Because I have tested this in several charts now. Suppose if someone is having Shravana in the 11th house, so he will be very generous towards his friends. And because of that, he might get into trouble also. 3rd Lord, very generous to the brothers.
Oh, okay.
So take the signification of the house and then apply the techniques. Because just from the Mahabali, I'm using this technique. But again, in the end, just like Babaji said, recovery is always there. It might not happen at that time. You might feel, you might think, why this has happened to me? He was my own brother. He was my own self, my own family member, my own friend. But later on, you will get it. Because at that time, we are not seeing the big picture. Regardless, we are not seeing the big picture these days in Kali Yuga. So generosity is the number one trait of these people. And just like I mentioned, very observant people. I know one guy, 4 planets or 3 planets in Shravana. Highly observant guy. He's the one who can be quiet all day long and do the work which no one can imagine. He can decipher biggest of the techniques, 4 planets in Shravana. You will find Shravana natives full of books. Yeah. Always reading. It can be through listening. It can be through at any pattern. But very observant people. And I'm pretty sure as soon as the people gonna hear what I have mentioned here, they will say, yes, it is working. So love for travel, as moon is involved, as it is a Chara Nakshatra, hungry for knowledge, just like I have mentioned.